Nice to meet you, Dr. Yunadi.
Nice to meet you.
I'd like to ask you the overview about the food in your country, relating to culture and custom in your country, religion. Could you give the overview about the food in your country, please?
Okay, thank you very much. The first thing I would like to let you know that Indonesia consists of more than 600 ethnic and around 700 ethnic languages. So each ethnic has its own culture, so which also affect the type of food they produce or they eat in every day of their life. So I'll give you, for example, in Sumatra, there's a number of ethnic in Sumatra, and one ethnic we call Minang in western part of Sumatra. They usually eat what they call rendang, and this is made of meat, and then with spicy, and then mixed with coconut milk. And then until they dry, they cook and dry it until dry. Then what they call, they got it, what they call rendang. And this type of food already spread all over the country because the culture of the Minang people are moving around all the country, and then they bring their own food wherever they live in the country. And this is one way or another how they spread the rendang to all of the country. So it is very difficult to give you a highlight on what type of food are very famous in each culture, because or in each ethnic, because each ethnic has their own, and I cannot memorize all. But at the national level, some type like rendang, we can find other food which originated from other area of Indonesia that I can share to you.
So if we ask how you characterize your food in your country?
In terms of geographical point of view, we have five main islands: Sumatra, Java, Kalimantan, Sulawesi, and then Papua. That's a big island. Mm-hmm. So in each big island, they have a number of ethnics. Mm-hmm. And each ethnic has its own unique type of food. But among the island, among the big island, in each island we can find a type of food or two or three types of food that are famous among all. Yeah. So that, for example, like in Sumatra, I mentioned rendang and then satay, for example. But this type of satay as well already spread all over the country and originated from Sumatra. And then they also modified when they arrive, when they get rich in other part of the country. I'll give you an example. For example, the satay from Sumatra, from Minang, for example, from the western part of Sumatra, they have their own unique sauces. When they reach to Java, they still use meat as the source for the satay, but they use the peanut sauce. And now both type of satay already spread all over the country as well. Yeah. So that's, for example, in Sumatra. In Java, where they originated the type of salad, what we call gado-gado, and this type of food originated from Java, and is already spread all over the country. So in Java, we can say that the famous one is, for example, gado-gado. And then in Sulawesi, for example, they have what they call soto, a kind of soup. And soto, well, what they call soto Makassar, because it's from Makassar, from Sulawesi, now is also spread all over the country, because it's because of the taste and because of the way they bring out from Sulawesi to all other part of the country.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The need for the rice, the main food, our first main food is rice. Yeah. So almost everybody eat rice. And that's the problem we are facing right now. We are lacking of supply of rice, and we import from Thailand because 240 million eat rice. Actually, it used to be that some part in eastern part of Indonesia, they used to eat sagu. We call it sagu. It is made from a tree, like a palm tree, something like that. And also cassava in some part of. But now they change to eat rice instead of sagu or cassava. So then almost everyone in Indonesia eat rice. And sometimes they eat rice 3 times a day. Morning, lunchtime, and dinner time, they eat rice. But some of them eat like bread or light breakfast, not rice in the morning. But mostly in lunch and dinner, they have to have rice. So a person of Indonesia, an Indonesian, when, for example, during lunchtime, they eat noodle or they eat somtam. And then they somebody asks, "Have you have your lunch?" No. having lunch or having dinner mean having rice. So if you don't have, if you haven't had your rice yet, it means you don't have dinner or lunch yet.
Even though you have noodle.
Yes, even though you have noodle. Have you had lunch? No, I just have noodle, something like that. It doesn't mean a lunch. So if you eat noodle, you eat sometime during lunchtime, that doesn't mean lunch for us.
But do you have noodle in?
Yes, we have noodle as well. We have noodle as well. And it's different type of noodle, different type of kind of how to cook noodle. Mm. Yeah.
So how are the meal times in your country? Is this like us? 3 times, morning, lunch and dinner?
Most of them eat meat and goat meat.
Goat?
Yes, goat meat.
Why is goat?
You know that the food in Indonesia influenced by many countries based on the relation between Indonesia and other countries. So long time ago, there was a trade between India, Arab, China, Europe to Indonesia. And they also bring their own food and then introduce to us. So you will find similar food like in India. For example, it's become already part of the culture of the ethnic. Like, for example, biryani in India. We call also biryani, and they have also in our own culture. So that's come from India. And also a lot of type of food from China as well, because they bring and introduce to our culture. That mean although we have the original food, but our food also influenced by other countries, not only our original one, something like that.
So basically for meat, the first is goat?
The first one is cow meat.
Cow.
Yeah, and then goat meat.
And then goat meat.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How about seafood?
Yes.
Based on your country, you have got many islands.
Yes.
So we have a lot of seafood.
Yes, we have a lot of seafood, and each ethnic cook different type of seafood. Yeah, like in the form of soup, there is clear soup, or used with the coconut meal, or they barbecue something like that. seafood barbecue with marinated with spicy, something like that.
Why is seafood not the number one meat that you use?
It actually depend on the ethnic group. Yeah, depend on the ethnic group. A certain ethnic group, they use seafood as their main food. Yeah, but other ethnic group mostly use vegetables instead of seafood. And then some part of the area, they use freshwater fish instead of seawater. They like freshwater more than seawater fish, something like that. The local one for the vegetable almost similar like in Thailand, yeah. So, for example, like they use in Gado Gado, they use a cucumber, and then morning glory, tomato, something like that. Mostly, all the vegetables are similar to the, because tropical countries are very similar.
Right. If you would like to talk about the number one of food of your country, what do you think the number one of your people?
I think the most of Indonesian love durian. Durian is still the first one as well. Yeah. Most of, in terms of like for example when you cook with like a soup, something like that, mostly they use coconut milk. Yes, coconut milk. So that's in every part of the ethnic, they use coconut milk for their one of the ingredient they use. The other is just like Indian spicy, like curry spicy or coriander, something like that.
Right.
Yes, yes.
Why is that comfort?
Because during the 16th or 17th century, the European came to Indonesia. They bought the spicy because the people during that time planted any plants that can produce spicy. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For Indonesian food, in your opinion, where do you think it come from? Which country that your food has been influenced?
India or Arab, the first one, and the second one, China, and the third one, I think, Europe. So mostly from India and Arabic country, and then second China, and then the third Europe or other countries.
So what type of food are there?
Like
are they stir fry, are they soup, or are they
in the form of soup is curry. So you will find curry or modified curry or modified soup in each area of Indonesia. With I believe it's originally come from India or Arab, something like that. And like China, in the form of cooking the salad, stir fry, that's mostly come from China.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So surely your food has been popular around the world. And are they different? The food is that different between around the world and the food in Indonesia itself?
Of course, it's different. It's different first in the form of taste, right? In the form of taste, it's different. Even though, as I mentioned, it come from India. When they come, when when it's come to Indonesia, then the locals modified to meet their taste. Yeah, to meet their taste. Then it's totally now, even though the same name, it could be different in terms of taste. Just like your food, for example.
Authentic.
Tom yam, for example, okay? Tom yam in the south, tom yam in the north, and tom yam in Bangkok, in tom yam in northeast, for example, is different. Is even though is the name is the same, mm-hmm. right? So that's what makes the difference between the other food or international food with the our food in terms of the taste, because they try to meet their taste. Consequently, the spices that they use are now becomes different. They also put some local ingredient into the food. Something like that.
So is your food normally curry or stir fry or deep fried? So normally, how is it cooked?
As I mentioned before, for example, when they we have we own curry, and for example, in India, for example, they use yogurt. We don't use yogurt, right? We use coconut milk, okay? And then we also have soup, like what we call soto. Mm-hmm. We use also milk, some without milk, but we put different ingredient. So each ethnic have their own characteristic or his unique type of soto, kind of soups, something like that.
So in every meal, normally your food is a lot of stir-fried food or a lot of deep-fried or a lot of something like soup or curry? Can you identify that? Or is this mixed?
Usually, where during, for example, lunch in a house, they have the first one, they have rice, and then they have soup, soup, and then vegetable, fish, or meat, something like that. Yeah.
So in every meal, lunch, breakfast, dinner, is the food the same, or they have something different that normally you eat for lunch, or eat that for breakfast, or just for dinner?
No, for breakfast, we have what we call, for example, usually people eat nasi goreng. Yeah, for the breakfast, or if they don't eat nasi goreng, maybe they have another light breakfast like bread, something like that. Yeah, but usually in the house we cook nasi goreng for the breakfast, and then for lunch we never eat nasi goreng, because usually nasi goreng is just for the morning in the breakfast. Or in the evening when you go out, for example, you will have nasi goreng, something like that. So usually the morning one will not be the same as the lunchtime, but the lunchtime can be the same as in the dinner.
So normally in Thailand, in every food we use fish sauce to make it salty. What you usually use in your country?
For our food, in terms of making salty, we usually use salt, or to make the aroma, then we use soy sauce. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So soy sauce in some ethnic, they prefer to use salty soy sauce, but in other part they prefer to use sweet soy sauce.
Can you give us like the key what it looks like in your food?
The first one I could mention, rendang. Yeah, that's belong to Indonesia. Even though you will find rendang, for example, in Malaysia or in Singapore, but it's originally from Indonesia, and that's I think the first famous one in the country. Right, it's made of meat, mixed with ingredients, and then you pour what you call it, coconut milk, and then you stir until it's dry. Then you will get the cooked meat of rendang with the aroma of the spicy, right? And the second one, nasi goreng, And the third one, gado-gado. The fourth one, soto. It can be different. And then the fifth one, I could say pecel. It's also like a salad with what you call it, peanut sauce. And also another one is satay. Right.
So can you tell us in each dishes, do they have the story, how it came from, and they have story in each dish, what the meaning of each dish, do they have a hidden meaning or something like that in each one? Or it's like this is inferred from somewhere, or this is located?
For rendang, it originally came from western part of Sumatra. Yeah, but now you can find it everywhere. Yeah, in everywhere in Indonesia you can find. So everywhere you go to Indonesia, you don't have any problem to find rendang. The second one, for example, as I mentioned, nasi goreng is the same as well.
The first one,
rendang.
Rendang. What does look like?
Look like it's made of meat, cow meat. And then they put ingredients, and then mix with coconut milk, and then they cook until dry, and then you will get the cooked meat, what we call rendang.
What usually eat in morning, lunch?
No, we usually eat in lunch. Or dinner, but some people might also eat in the morning together with nasi goreng. Mm-hmm. Okay, nasi goreng. I think I don't know exactly where it's originated from, which province. But now everywhere you can find, everywhere in Indonesia. If you stay in the hotel, the breakfast they will serve nasi goreng as well, mm-hmm. right? And then the third one is gado-gado.
Which meal?
And usually we eat during the breakfast.
During the breakfast.
Uh-huh. And then you can mix with, for example, fried fish or fried peanuts, something like that. Or you can mix with all other. But you don't. Usually when you eat nasi goreng, you don't use soup. You don't eat soup together with nasi goreng. So when you eat nasi goreng, you don't use any other liquid food, something like that. So just all dry food, mm-hmm. right? And then gado-gado is a salad. A salad where they pour a mixed salad where they pour the peanut sauce on top of it, for example. And this one also you can find everywhere in the country.
Where it came from, this one?
It came from Java. It came from Java. But now you can find it everywhere in the country. And the fourth one is...
the third one, we can have it for lunch or dinner?
We can eat for lunch, and we can eat also, for example, like in between lunch, between breakfast and lunch, you eat gado-gado, and then lunchtime you eat another lunch with rice. Because as I mentioned before, even though you already eat gado-gado, big one, you haven't had lunch yet. And then the fourth one, like satay, you can find satay pour with peanut sauce, and then mix with ketchup, something like that, like sweet sauce. Something like that. And then another one is pecel. So all I mentioned, you can find everywhere in
the last one is
pecel. It's just like similar like gado-gado. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And another one like the soup soto, which you can also find in all over the country. Mm-hmm. So all these six already spread all over the country. So anywhere you go, you can find it. You can find them.
Is it all healthy food?
And the other day, for example, gado-gado, they use fresh vegetables. Yeah, the gado-gado, they use fresh vegetable. When with the pechel, they use steamed vegetable, something like that.
So I would like to ask, you have food that is very easy to cook and people like to eat, or the meal that can be cooked very easily?
I think the one that you can cook easily is gado-gado. Yeah, it's like you prepare a som tam. Yeah, it doesn't take a long time. So it's much odd. I think the first one is much easier is nasi goreng. Nasi goreng, because you take white rice, after you cook white rice, and then you put spicy and then oil, and then where you cook with pour the white rice, and then you cook. It's much easier. And now they already sell the instant ingredient for nasi goreng, so it's even much faster to cook. Yeah.
And everything is changing. Your culture of food has changed since the past and present. What are the trends in the future? Is it changing?
I think just the same like here as well. The young people now much more interested in eating Western food. So you will see the number of McDonald's, KFC are growing. Yeah. But still a lot of people prefer to eat the local food like I mentioned before. And now there are growing number as well the local food. They have branches overseas like in Singapore and Malaysia where they offer Indonesian tradition dishes. The problem with our dishes is that you need not like, for example, Thai food. They can cook easily, cook in fresh, and then serve in fresh. Like rendang, you need less about 1 hour, for example, to cook, or more than 1 hour. That's not good for the restaurant where you have to to serve it as soon as possible, something like that. And most of our food take longer to cook, and that's another problem on how to establish, for example, restaurant overseas to promote our food. That's a big problem. But some of them you can cook easily or faster.
So do you think Indonesian people stick to ready to eat or ready to make meal more than cook by themselves?
In the outside of the city, most of them cook by themselves. But in the city, more and more people like to go to the restaurant or to the high street food because sometimes it's cheap and you don't have to waste your time to cook. Because sometimes if you cook 1 hour or 2 hours, you cook and then you just eat for 5 minutes. So they don't want to spend a long time just go outside, for example, and that. That's why the trend is similar like here. I see that growing numbers of restaurants, and every restaurant is full, right? But actually, I think it's much healthier if you can cook by yourself, right?
So as we are talking, we didn't talk about sweets or drinks in Indonesia. Can you just tell us the idea of your main sweets or drinks?
The drink, for the traditional drink, they have what they call cendol, es teler, where you mix like different kind of food with, and then put syrup, something like that. There are several kind which I don't know exactly the name of the drink. Yeah, we have sweets like for the dessert, just like similar like here, where you serve cakes or fruits at different type of cakes. And usually it's also unique based on the culture or the ethnic. Mm-hmm.
So you have like the food that is related to festivals, celebrations or your custom or your something like that. Just give us the example.
A celebration, in celebration, they have yellow rice. They have yellow rice for the celebration. They prepare yellow rice like a mountain, like a mountain. And then when they serve, they cut from the top first. And on the side of the mountain of the yellow rice, they put all other side dishes where you can, for example, peanut or tempeh or tofu, something like that, or vegetable or gado gado. So you take the rice from the top, and then you can take all the side dishes. That usually they use for the celebration, like for the celebration of your birthday, celebration of the Independence Day, something like that.
Hopefully it will be the very last one, the culture and the manner at the table. Have you got any special do's and don'ts at the table?
Well, do and don't, as I mentioned, it's a lot of ethnicities in Indonesia. In certain ethnic, usually you have to eat with your hand.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
So no cutlery?
No.
No spoon,
no spoon. Just spoon. They have spoon just to take for the soup.
Right.
But you have to eat with your hand. Although it's not easy for those who don't get used
first
to it.
Practice.
Right? And in the other part, they have to use the spoon.
Okay.
Right? So today they never use their hand, for example. So on the international basis, they use spoon.
So now we learn a lot.
Right, no.
So if you said some part use hand in the family, in the house, so now still use hand?
Even in certain restaurant, they use hand.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It depends on which area you go, so in the ethnic. So you will find they use hand during eating in the restaurant.
And have a small mold to
Right.
use your hand.
Yes, that's right.
So do you have Indonesian restaurant in Thailand?
Yes, there is one in Sukhumvit. There is one in Sukhumvit.
Only one.
I would like to give you opinion about our project that we already gave you the information and you already gave us valuable information. Can you tell us what is your opinion about this project and how do you feel?
I believe that this project is excellent one for Rajabat because this is the first time I heard about the project in terms of food, right? And it is very good for the students or for other communities to know other foods from other ASEAN countries. I'm lucky to have chance to work here like for a number of years than to know the Thai food. But back home, I just know only tom yum because you can find it also everywhere now, tom yum. But I never heard about som tam or other type of food of from Thailand. If I have known it before, then it's much easier for me to understand about the food. And through this e-learning, where you provide information on foods from other ASEAN countries, this is another side where you can introduce the other part of the culture of the country in ASEAN to your community, like your students. Not only culture in terms of art or performing art, something like that, but also the culture. And the way how they eat, for example, what do and what don't, something like that.
We would like to thank you very much for your cooperation and your time today. Thank you, Dr. Yunadi.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.